Hi there, and welcome back. In the previous video, we started our new game, and in this video, we're ready to start adding assets. To start adding assets or objects into our game, we'll go into the 2D world. And you can go into the 2D world either by double-clicking on the 2D world or clicking the edit icon in the corner. So let's click on the icon. And once we click that, we go into the view called the World Workspace. We'll cover every part of it once we start using it. But in this video, we're adding assets into our game. So that's what we're gonna do now. The assets that are currently available in our game can be found in the asset panel, and it's the far left side of the window. So these are currently the assets that are available for us to use. To add new assets to our game, we can use the asset library at the top of the asset panel. And when we click on it, we get the list of all the assets that are available in Buildbox by default. The very first items in the list, we have primitive shapes. And these shapes are perfect to use for prototyping your game. And for beginners, and not only for beginners, it's our recommendation to prototype your game before you start adding artwork into it. And that's exactly what we're gonna start with. To add any of these items into our game, we can simply double click on any of these items. So let's add a circle into our game and let's double click on it. Once you double click on it, you can see that we get that circle asset added into our asset panel. You can exit the asset library by either clicking the X or clicking on the asset library. Once we exit out the asset library, now we can select the asset that we just added. And once we select it, at the far right, we have the option panel. And here we have all the options that are available for the selected asset. Here at the very top, we have the option for name. And let's change our name to player. Once we typed out the name and clicked enter, we can see that in our asset panel, the circle is now renamed to player. The first game that we'll be creating in this series will be a Flappy type style game. Also, at the end of the videos, where it's applicable, we'll give you challenges that you should try to complete before you continue to the next video. And the challenge that you should complete before going to the next video is adding two more assets, a rectangle for ground and a triangle for enemy. And after you add those assets, rename the rectangle to ground and a triangle to enemy. So go ahead and do that. And in the next video, we're going to be placing our assets into the scene.